Dave Viewers, I'm still your online tutor, Esomna of Goodwill Online Maths. Today, I'm going to be presenting a radical equation as I have on the board. Please, if you are new in this channel, please consider subscribing. You can also hit the bell button, the bell icon, so that you'll be notified once I upload a new video. You can as well share it to your learned colleagues so that we can eliminate mathematics phobia. So if you have look at the board really well, you can see I have the cube root of x squared minus 9 divided by the cube root of x plus 3 equal to 3. And I'm required to find the value of x. So if you can remember the rules of SOD, whenever we have a SOD expressed in a unique square root, that is the same square root, whether it is separated by multiplication and division, we are permitted to give it the same root. Say, and it must be described with the same root. So if you have here, I have the cube root of x minus 9 divided by the cube root of x plus 3 equal to 3. So if you have there, they have the same roots. That is the root of x minus 9 and the root of x plus 3. So here I can say that this is the cube root of x squared minus 9 divided by x plus 3. And this is equal to 3. So here we are one step gone down. So if you can see here, I have the cube root of x squared minus 9 divided by x plus 3, and it's equals to 3. So at this point, this is a cube root and the left hand side. So for me to be able to eliminate this cube root, you know that the opposite of cube root is power of 3. So I can raise this to the left hand side to the power of 3 and raise the right hand side to the power of 3 so that I can be able to eliminate this what? Cube root. So let's do that together. Power of 3, power of 3. So that this can actually cancel out this. Then I'm left with x squared minus 9 divided by x plus 3. And it's equals to 3 raised to the power of 3 is equal to 27. So at this point now, I have that my x squared minus 9 divided by x plus 3 is equal to 27. This is like the square root of x minus 9. You know that 9 is the same thing as 3 raised to the power of 2. So I can replace my 9 with 3 raised to the power of 2. So I can have that x squared minus 3 raised to the power of 2. Since 9 is the same thing as 3 raised to the power of 2, because 3 raised to the power of 2 is like 3 times 3, which is 9, divided by x plus 3. And it is equals to 27. So at this point, if you observe this numerator at the left-hand side, you can see that this is x squared and this is 3 what? Squared. So actually, and there is subtraction here. This is a difference between these two squared. So you observe well that in difference of 2 squared, let's say I have my a squared minus my b squared. This is the same thing as my a plus b multiplying my a minus b. So since I have this like this, I can say that my x plus 3, applying the difference of 2 squares rule, is going into x minus 3 divided by my x plus 3. Equal to 27. So this is x plus 3 and this is actually x plus 3. So I can say x plus 3 should cancel out x plus 3. So at the end you can see I have my x minus 3 is equal to 27. Then for us to be able to find the value of x, this is x minus 3. So for us to be able to move this to the other hand side, I can say that I should add 3 to both sides. So I can say my x minus 3 plus 3 is equal to my 27 plus 3. That is adding 3 to both sides for us to be able to find the value of x. Then I have that my x minus 3 plus 3 is 0 is equal to 27 plus 3 is 30. So the solution or the value of x that can satisfy this equation is that x must be equal to 30. Thank you for watching. Thank you for viewing. Do not fail to subscribe to my channel, YouTube Esonoh for Goodwill Online Maths, Facebook Esonoh for Goodwill Maths Class, so that you'll be notified once I upload a new video. Thank you.